Alright, so welcome back to another episode of my 1.4 playthrough. Today it's finally time to go to hell, defeat Wall of Flesh and enter hard mode. I am pretty terrified to be honest, because I don't know how difficult hard mode will be. I expect to be one, probably two shot, and if we get lucky maybe we can take three hits. But it's gonna be interesting for sure. And I'm also not looking forward to fighting Wall of Flesh. I mean, we have water walking potions and we have like most of the stuff that we need for hell. I'm not gonna build an arena, by the way. But I don't know, man. Wall of Flesh is just not my favorite fight, especially not after doing Master Modes for the Worthy No Hits. Which I'm still working on, by the way, on the side. I've been working on it the last couple of days, which is why I didn't really upload anything besides the playthrough. It's just that I want to get this Master for the Worthy video out, and then after that I want to work on other videos again. It's gonna take a bit, but I'm trying to make the video as interesting as possible by making all of the fights unique. For example, I get both of the twins into phase 2 before I actually kill them. And just other tiny twists to make it more interesting. And I also plan like a bigger surprise in the video that I haven't done on my channel before. So it takes a while, and it's not exactly easy for the Worthy Master. It's actually kind of difficult to some degree. Mainly because stuff like Wall of Flesh has so much HP. Like, Jesus, Wall of Flesh has like 29,000 HP in that difficulty. And she just goes ham really early at like 10% HP, and you have to burst down so much HP while she's so fast. I don't know, man. I can't describe how difficult Wall of Flesh was. I was surprised. But I also didn't have an arena built. I just removed some towers because I wanted to have an interesting fight. So yeah. Anyways, I did a couple of things off screen, as you can see. Mainly unintentional. I didn't mean to. But we did build a elevator that actually goes all the way down to hell. And the reason I did that off-screen was because I was recording and I wanted to, but I don't like the way the recording turned out, because I was recording in the morning, and in the morning my voice is very deep, which isn't a bad thing, technically, but I also have, like, I have really, really hard time showing emotions, as much of a meme as it is on this channel. German depression ASMR is, like, at its very peak when I'm recording in the morning. I'm gonna show you some clips. Like, it will be just a tiny bit of talking so you can see what I talked about and tell what it's like, but I did not want to upload the entire episode, not when I sound like that, because I don't know, I sound good in the last couple of episodes. My commentary has improved and I actually sound happier than I usually did, so I didn't want to change it and like make people think something went wrong. And I don't know, it's just me overthinking things, as always. You know me by now. So anyways, enjoy the tiny compilation, I guess, of stuff that I did in that episode. Or mainly said, because all we did was build the elevator. And in the meanwhile, I'm heading down the elevator, and we're gonna actually prepare to fight Wall of Flesh. Also, one moment. Why is the elevator 3 blocks wide? Oh wait, yeah, right. I tried to make it look good with T-Edit, but then abandoned it halfway through. My bad. Also, we have the worst elevator in existence, by the way. I don't know if I'm gonna cut it in, but basically, the elevator goes through two mushroom biomes, one of which has a spider biome in it, and it goes through the underground jungle. And it literally hit like 4 or 5 lava pools I had to get rid of. Needless to say, I didn't have a good time making this elevator. Alright, so hello and welcome back to another episode. Today I found out that I'm a massive idiot, and I mean, let's face it, we all knew that already. So what happened is, I overwrote the save file by accident when I was going for no hits, and the last episode is basically completely undone. It's like I never went into the dungeon, it's not even explored on the map. So yeah, that's just wonderful, to be honest. Really exciting stuff. I wanna try to avoid water, because water in a elevator is just so annoying. So I think I'm gonna try to here, and just hope the dryad isn't gonna... Okay, whatever, dryad is gonna die then. How happy is she? So many others crammed into one spot, the grass is doomed, I hate it, I like the... Jiboto, the witch doctor, resonates with every fiber of my being. I hate Jim Mulligan, the golfer's just... Yeah, I hate the golfer as well, exactly. He's so violent, dude, and like, just... God, I don't like the golfer at all. I agree. I can guarantee you one thing, though. Her happiness will drop when she goes down the elevator with me. She will not be happy anymore. That's what you get for complaining. Oh yeah, she knows. We're going to hell. Not happening again, seriously. Okay, and okay, there we go, and there we go. I should be, yeah. I can open this without getting killed just much. I didn't see those traps. Also, I'm a bit tired today. You might be able to hear, so I'm sorry for that. It's also really early in the morning, so my voice is probably a lot deeper than it usually is. No. I'm heart stuck. Jesus, okay. That's right. Just to spite me, there's this tiny lava pool here. Not a big danger, but it just requires some, like, you know, thinking. There you go. And forcing me to think is usually not a good idea, seeing how, you know, I fucked up my backups a couple of times. Just look at this pool of lava. It is literally made for me. The world generated it in advance, knowing exactly where I'm gonna build my elevator, and just placed it there so I have to move it out of the way. My life in a nutshell. Alright. This is actually kind of good. I forgot about it. If we remove all of these blocks, we have water down here to fall into. Never mind, it's evaporating. I forgot. Fast, get obsidian. Well, I still can. Oh, okay, never mind. Not again. Alright. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to cancel my fall for the time being. Did I take my shadow key with me? Ugh, okay, why am I just this stupid? Jesus Christ. I should just empty my inventory as well, while I'm at it. I'm not deleting anything, don't worry. It's all gonna be okay. Maybe. Probably not. Okay. Water walking is important, so I'll take these with me. And I'm gonna put stone in the hotbar. I don't know why I'm using the snake charmers anymore. I don't really think it's useful. It's a cool accessory, or, you know, tool. But I don't really have much use for it anymore. Okay. I'll take this one and let's head down for real this time. Longest fall ever. I don't even have a mount, do I? No. Wow. I also don't have a pet yet. This has been one dry playthrough, honestly. I really hope I can spice it up a bit in hard mode, but I'm gonna have to find a pet, get a mount, build the NPC houses, build something in general, not be lazy. I think the playthrough will just slow down a bit until I'm done with Master Mode Nuggets, because I really like focusing on those right now and I want to get it out of the way before anything. Don't! I'm not even paying attention, I have my bottle of water in my hand. I went back up because I didn't have a shadow key. And guess what I didn't pick up? A fucking shadow key. I am really worried about myself when I do playthroughs. Like, how did I survive until now if I'm just... Holy dude. I have a couple really, really interesting video ideas I want to work on once I'm done with the Master Mode Nuggets. I really can't wait to try them out. And I'm gonna be actually trying a different format of video as well that potentially might be one of the best on my channel. Like, I really like the idea of it. I'm not gonna talk about it just yet though. All you have to do is wait. I will bring it, or like, bring the first episode eventually. It shouldn't take that long. What do we have here? Treasure magnets? Wait, what? That's a thing? I didn't know that. Can be worn in vanity slots. So, why does it tell me it can be worn in a vanity slot? But then... It says no stats will be gained. Oh, this is social. Oh wait, so I can like... No. Am I being stupid? Please don't answer that. That wasn't a serious question. Can be one event. I guess it just says it so you... Oh wait, all of the items do. Oops. I swear I've played this game before. God, this is embarrassing. Alright, moving on. I want to see how much the range is increased, but I didn't even know that's a thing, to be honest. And I love it. That is an amazing accessory. I wonder if we will find more new things. Also, yes, I still use quad barrel shotguns. You cannot change my mind, guys. People are saying I should try to defeat Moonot with this weapon. Honestly, I might. I don't actually know if I'm gonna use it against Wall of Flesh yet. It would be smart not to, but we all know, not smart, so... I might. God, just thinking about what I sound like when I record in the morning, by the way, I have, like, no energy in my voice at all. Like, I was shocked when I heard the recording. I like my morning voice because it's deeper and I just find it more pleasant or soothing to listen to. And yes, I find my own voice soothing to listen to every now and then. Just give me that moment of glory, please. But, like, the morning voice is... I like the tone of it, but there's no energy in it at all. Like, you... Like, I really sound like I didn't want to wake up that day. Wait, how do I prevent this from... Okay. And before people point it out again, because I get a lot of comments, hey bro, you sound depressed, are you okay? Yes, I'm doing okay. Better than ever before, almost. Actually, no, I'll take that almost back. I'm doing better than ever before, to be honest. Shoutouts to Free. What? I didn't say anything. I also have to say that so far, this is probably my favorite playthrough I've done. I don't know, I just really enjoy the way it turned out, and I find it really into... God, I sound so selfish today. No, I'm... Ugh, goddammit, I should just not talk. I can't win. I lost. I did actually change the quick trash, by the way. Like the shift thing, because people pointed out you have to do it in the main menu, not in the actual menu. So thank you for that, to the people that pointed it out. I'm glad I have it fixed, because it caused a lot of pain and suffering for both the viewers and me. Okay, so actually, I don't even know why I'm building this platform. I think what I will be doing is, I will be going to the left side and just use water walking and obsidian skin to get through. And then I will remove some of the towers, make sure I can walk through, and then just build a normal path. I don't know how difficult Wall of Flesh is in Master Mode only anymore, it's been a while since my no-hits. As long as this isn't as difficult as, or like, For the Worthy Master, we should be fine. Because in For the Worthy Master, she actually took, like, more than half of hell. And obviously her hitbox is smaller as well in For the Worthy Master. Jesus, I cannot describe how difficult it is, really. Like, I know I'm not the best player. I never said I am, and like, especially as of recently, because I haven't been playing much, I'm just not as consistent as I used to be. But even then, like, I'm not saying Wall of Flesh is difficult, because I'm bad at fighting her. She genuinely is insanely difficult on For the Worthy Master to no-hit. At least without an arena. Like, you can build the easy arena where you can just, like, remove all of hell, basically. Or, like, just make it really hollow and then have, like, a lay of platforms in the middle. And then all you have to do is just literally walk and she can't hit you, if you know how to do it. That one's like easy mod, I refuse to do that. I just never build an arena for no hits. I just enjoy the way it, like I do it right now, and yeah, that made it really difficult. But it's raining like crazy today. Speaking of which, what do you guys think of rain? I know it's a bit off topic or like random, at least I feel like it, but I don't know. I just like to talk about rain because a lot of people seem to share the opinion. Like my opinion, and it's nice to see if people do, but like rain is the most soothing thing in existence, and it's just the best thing ever. I love when it's raining. I love rain even more, like summer rain, you know, the rain that happens at like the end of really really hot days. Oh, it's just so good. There's like, I usually don't like passing out to stuff. I don't like it at all, really. I never really do it, but I do like actually just play some like 10-hour rain sounds every now and then to pass out to. There's some good videos on YouTube, and man, I sleep like a baby when I listen to those. I regret picking the quad barrel shotgun for hell, but I'm sticking with what I chose. But the rain is getting worse though, Jesus. Oh yeah, then there's Minecraft Dungeons, Jesus. I wasn't interested in it, I didn't even know it was a thing before I heard about it. And then it released and I was like kind of neutral to it. And then I watched some gameplay on it, and just in general, what it was like. Oh god, okay. And honestly, it looks mediocre, I think is a good way of describing it. I mean, I wouldn't be too interested in it just from the looks of it. But like, Jesus. Is it true that it only is like 5 hours of playtime? And that like, it just isn't worth it at all? Because that's kind of sad, to be honest. It looks like it could be something that could like be a lot of fun. I don't even have money to reforge this. How much? 16? Jesus, okay. Potion of Return? What? Teleports you home and creates a portal. Use portal to return when you are done. That is amazing, what? I didn't know that's a thing either. We found 2 new items today. And I've been playing 1.4 like crazy. Alright, well, sure, I'll take them. Also this music. Can we make this music stop right now, please? God, that reminds me, I was in a call with someone and was fighting Queen Bee. And while I was fighting Queen Bee, the other person I was in call with just suddenly screen shares YouTube and plays Windy Day music while I'm fighting Queen Bee. And if you remember, like 2 episodes ago, I said that like my hell would be fighting enraged Queen Bee while listening to Windy Day theme. Oh, dude, it was so painful. It's literally hell. I had to listen to Windy Day music while fighting Queen Bee. And I couldn't do anything, because if I mute screen share, I would mute them as well. Like, most evil person ever, seriously. You know who you are. Shame. No, it was funny though. My suffering is always funny. Just like, don't ever do that again. Anyone, please. I'd prefer if we can just acknowledge that Windy Day theme doesn't exist. I might have to put my glasses on. Which, yes, by the way, I do have glasses. I don't have to wear them ever, but I prefer wearing them while playing certain games. I don't know. It's like I'm on the verge of having to wear them, and I just prefer not to, though. It depends. I don't mind wearing them, and I look decent with them, but I don't know. I'm not the glasses guy. I'm even less of a contact lens person, though. I do not want anything in my eyes. Just the thought of that makes me like, oh, no, let's not. Oh yeah, I've been playing some Celeste recently, and god, I kind of honestly forgot how much of a great game Celeste is. I mean, I knew it, but like, I kind of just had it in the back of my mind and didn't think about it. And like, the reason I started playing it again is because I bought it for a friend and watched them play through most of it. Like, they're at B-set right now. Oh my god, dude, Celeste is so much fun, I forgot. Like, I've been redoing Chapter 9 and a couple of B-sides. For example, I'm actually kind of proud of that. 6B only took me 30 minutes or 35 minutes to do, after not playing the game for months and getting back into it. I used to struggle so much with 6B, and I just did it pretty smoothly with, like, not many deaths. I don't know. And Chapter 9 was just, yeah, Chapter 9 is insane. We all know that, I think, if you played Celeste. But to anyone that hasn't played Celeste, it's a must-play, honestly. It's such a good game. One of the only games ever, I would say, or like, I don't say it often, but I think it's one of the only games that doesn't have any flaws. Like, I'm not gonna directly say it's flawless, because it probably has flaws if you look hard enough, and I'm kind of biased by it. Or for it? Okay, are you biased by something or for something? I don't even know any English anymore, man. But yeah, like, you get the point, right? It's a really, really good game. Can you stop giving me treasure magnets? Anyways, I've been having a great time with the game, and I don't know. I just want to play the game more again. I just don't know what to go for. I used to speedrun it for a while. You guys remember I uploaded, I think, 1A and 1B. Oh, 2B? No, 2A. My brain, what is happening? And I did even more off-screen, but like, yeah, I don't know, man. Speedrunning the game is not something I want to do again, because I, like, enjoyed it. But it's so difficult and so stressful. I also speedrun Dark Souls 3 for a while, because I really like speedrunning, and Dark Souls 3 speedrun is really, really interesting. And it's also an insanely difficult speedrun. Some of you probably know about it if you've watched one before. But like, Jesus, dude. It's actually hard to describe how difficult a Dark Souls 3 speedrun is. It has like one of the hardest, if not the hardest skip I've ever seen in a speedrun. I am actually gonna finish the rest of the Hell Exploration until here, pretty much, off screen. Because I just want to get progress done. I've been recording for long enough, and I want to get the episode out today, maybe even? Question mark? I'm not sure if I can do that. Actually, no, probably tomorrow. But regardless, I want to do that, and I'm also gonna prepare like a bridge, which I will build with T-Edit to save myself some time. I'm sorry for that if you don't like it, but I just see no reason in building a bridge if I'm not gonna implement it into my video. And building a bridge, let's face it, is not interesting. So yeah. And then, with the bridge, we're gonna try to dynamite Waterfish. Shouldn't be that difficult, to be honest. I might not even need to destroy the houses. I can just, like, build a bridge, like, here. And the houses, I think, they're probably gonna go until, like, here-ish, kind of. Maybe even only here. And if I build the bridge until here, that might be enough to kill the wall. Dynamite kills her pretty quickly. Even on Master. Okay. Yeah. Sounds like a good idea. In that case, see ya in a bit. Hopefully the hollow doesn't spawn on my house, because I'm not gonna have anything to defend myself with. Oh god, if that happens, I'm screwed. I need to build soon. Anyways, I can't say goodbye. see ya in an hour or so. It won't take too long. So I am back, I got a voodoo doll and I prepared the path after clearing out hell. So yeah, let's go for it. Just gotta make sure I got my water walking active and hard reach because I can. Taunts is gonna be nice, Hunters is gonna be nice. Oh, there's another Voodoo Doll Express delivery. Okay. Kind of wanna do it before even my enemies spawn. Yeah, let's just go for it. Yes. Hoping for the bet. Why can I not drop it? I literally pressed drop like 5 times. After I unfavored it this. Can I do it now? There we go. Alright, let's see. Shouldn't be that bad. Oh my god, she's so... Jesus. After fighting the For the Worthy version, this looks so weird. Because in For the Worthy, she's so fucking tiny and like has so much more HP. I need to be a bit more careful, slow down a bit. Did I just heal 90 HP? Okay. Quad barrel shotgun. Okay. I told you guys, quad barrel shotgun is the meta. I even finished water flush off of it. Okay, this wasn't the cleanest fight. I haven't done this in a long, long time. I practiced it a bit against the For the Worthy version just to see if it's viable. But like, I am just not used to the timing anymore. Plus, For the Worthy is what I've been fighting for a long time. And it's completely different though. Like, the water flush For the Worthy moves in like different speeds and whatnot, so. And has a different hitbox. So, this was weird, but it worked, and I'm not complaining. Right, I made this, yeah. There we go. So, we get the relic, obviously. Not this music. Demon Heart, Pwn Hammer, which I'll replace this with. Ruthless Laser Rifle, and a Source Rambam. Guess we're going mage? Yeah, I'm okay with that. Yeah, why not? Oh no, at least. Okay, well, in that case, that's the episode. Honestly, that's all I wanted to get. I'm surprised we got it first try. I actually prepared the bet up there because I was expecting it to take multiple tries, but no, we got it done. We still don't have Terror Spark boots, so I do want to go for those, and we have a couple of other things to go for, but overall, that was really, really good. So yeah. Anyways, and let me just like, there we go. If you enjoyed the episode, then let me know by, I don't know, just leaving a comment or maybe even a like. All kinds of support are definitely appreciated, and the last few episodes have been doing really well, so thank you for that, I really appreciate it. I will upload more often again once I'm done with the Worthy Nohead, so expect that to be the next video probably. And yeah, with that being said, see you in the next one, and I forgot what I say at the end. Yeah.